What the heck, Andrew? Oh my god, I just wanted to record a full game, but he's streaming right now. Oh my god, alright. Well, I guess we're up against Andrew. For those that don't know, Andrew is my brother, and he's streaming right now in the other room. I just wanted a Fafnir full gameplay because I got a new strat. And the new strat I haven't shown to YouTube, I've shown to my stream. And that is Specialist Blessing. Now, you might be like, wait a second. Specialist Blessing does not give damage. That's okay, because it gives 20 MP5 and 10% cooldown reduction right away. And as you may know from my previous Fafnir videos, Fafnir needs cooldown reduction, and he needs mana sustain. And Mage's Blessing, you don't get the cooldown reduction forever, and you don't get the MP5, you know, unless you have zero mana. Like, if you're at half mana, you only get 10, which is, like, nothing. So you can spam your abilities more as Fafnir with, like, little downside. Yes, it takes a little bit longer to clear, but I feel like it's safer. Plus, once you get Special Blessing evolved, which takes forever unless you're in dragon form, you can do some nice stuff. You know, you have some movement speed, help juke some stuff, you know? Yeah, he took some damage, I took more. Not good for me. His shell. I probably should have gone Bracer, but I need beads for his ultimate. I want to get level 4 so I get my heal. Yeah, so Special Blessing gives us the early mana and cooldown sustain that we need. Fafnir's early scaling isn't that much from, you know, just Mage's Blessing. Like, yeah, you can clear the wave a little bit easier, but I feel like being able to spam my abilities more helps more, because, like, I get my one on cooldown faster, and I don't gotta worry about my mana, because, you know, I can just spam it. Okay. This is a ranked duel, by the way, and we are masters with Fafnir. I'm sorry if I'm not talking too much right now. For the most part, Fafnir is pretty much just clear the wave early. I probably shouldn't have tried to fight this. Oh well, I'm dead. That's okay. If I had the mana, I could have fought it. I could have leaped away. Something was kind of telling me I could have fought it, just because, you know, Fafnir dragon form strong, Cupid squishy. But I should have ran. That's fine. We don't really lose much off that since I took red buff, and we don't lose the wave either, which is fine. 600 gold behind is not bad as Fafnir. Helps me come back with my passive, you know. Fafnir, if you have not watched my previous Fafnir gameplays, I recommend it, although the builds are, you know, I went a different build. So it's a little outdated in terms of that. However, I will talk about how Fafnir's late game is so incredibly strong, can probably compete with almost every god in duel, except for, like, maybe Hebo, Poseidon. He can compete with Kronos, surprisingly. Even though Kronos' late game is insane. It's just, once you get to late game, you can't miss anything. Now, the Fafnir's late game is super strong. The strongest things on him are Bancroft's cooldown, MP5, you know, it's things of that nature. Alright, he is going Transcendence. That's a pretty good Cupid build. That's usually what I'll do as well. Bracer would have been nice, but... And I can counter ult him, but still, having the beads for when I can't is just really... You need it against Cupid. Cupid can really screw you over with his ult, you know? I'm I'm pretty much spamming my heal as much as I can because I have the mana sustain to do so. If I had Mage's Blessing, I would actually run out of mana if I were spamming it as much as I am now. Plus, I wouldn't get it as fast. I'm at the point where I can pretty much clear wave effectively. I shouldn't have done that. Oh well, that's fine. I should have leaped away first. Or I mean ulted first. Like right away rather than waiting. I was just taking too much damage, but that's fine. We got the late game, that's what matters. With Fafnir, you really just gotta stick with it, you know? You could be super far behind and still win. I've played against a few Fafnirs myself, and it's exactly the same. Fafnir loses early game, but if you don't beat him, if you don't snowball like crazy, then you're not gonna win. And since I'm taking so many buffs, I'm actually even in level with him, which is really nice. I keep taking XP camps and everything. Also, I use my beats there. I don't know if he noticed if I use my beats or not. I probably shouldn't have done that. Okay, nice. Nice jukes. Very nice jukes. Oh, that scared me, man. Just the instant explode. Alright, I might be able to get him here. Actually, no, I can't ult. Because since I don't have beads, I can't ult because my ult is my only way out of his ultimate right now. Unfortunately. Yeah, otherwise I'd go in on him. With Fafnir, you're always looking for when is your opponent's escape down. That's when you go in with your hammer ultimate. Get them trapped in it. Dragon form can kill people very easily. But obviously, I need my ult to counter ult, so kind of sucks. He should be going for red instead of pressuring me here. Could be getting more XP and gold. Ooh, that was a nice heart bomb. Alright, I guess I need a bag. I could stay for one more wave. I have my counter ult, worst case scenario. Ah, but do I stay for red buff? Yes. Dang it! You had so many autos. I just needed to get my one ult. I could remember I can't ult unless he. Well, I got my beads up. Maybe I could have ulted. I can only ult freely if my beads are up. So here's the thing, right? He's 3-0 and I'm the same level because I keep taking these buffs. So it's like we don't even have it. We're not even behind. Yeah, we're behind in gold, but I mean, that's not such big a deal since considering I almost have my core items online. My core items are Bancroft's cooldown. Like, so cooldown would be breastplate in this situation. And oh, he did take my buff though. And pen, which is would be Spirit of Magus. So once I get Spirit of Magus, we should be good. Gem Viso will help, but it's not like I can still fight him without Gem Viso. So I don't think it's a core item, more of a luxury item. I need Beta's escape here. Okay. Well, I needed to not use my hammer and bait his escape, so rip. Oh, I missed. That's so bad. Watch yourself. He's doing quite a bit of damage. I keep screwing up. What the heck? That was a little bit strange. Okay. That's fine. Alright. 6 seconds, I can get him. Is that gonna kill? Oh, 1 HP. Very nice. Very nice. Very nice. I should go for his blue buff if I can. Ooh, I need to hurry though. So he tried going back in to heart bomb me when I was untransformed, but my minions were in the way, which is super good for me. Also, I need back. Hopefully he doesn't come this way. Okay, perfect. Alright, let me get... I could get Blink, Thorns, Sprint. Sprint is good against Cupid, because Cupid is literally all slows. Alright, so he's skipping his defense, which can be dangerous. It can be super dangerous. I'm going to get my Spirit of Magus online soon. Okay, I clear now without without needing to use my everything. We will need anti-heal as well. Oh, he should not have gone for that. Ooh, but I missed. I missed twice. Oh, that's unfortunate. Missing that many times is really bad. Very nice. So when he's going for the heart bombs, he's walking in a straight line. I would assume he would want to like go for the heart bomb and then juke, which is why I didn't wait until he went right for the heart bomb. Like I fired it right as he was making a beeline for it, if that makes sense. Like he was still a good distance away from it. I feel like he was going to juke right next to the heart bomb, so I didn't give him the chance. All right, so now we have blue buffs. Let me get my Spirit of Magus. So now we are ahead, which is so weird because we're one kill behind. The duel can be weird like that. Usually when I'm ahead, like when I have the extra kills, I'm barely ahead. So fortunately this happened to Andrew this time. It's kind of funny, he's in the other room. So his escape is down. Ah, but my ult's not up. Still did a good amount of damage, though. Whoops, that was bad. Kind of wanted to use his escape. Oh, 34 health. 34 health. Very nice. That's because I got physical defense, so. Alright, we can take the star. We can do this. So people kind of make fun of me that every time I do a Fafnir full gameplay, I point out this mechanic, but I don't care. There's always going to be at least one person that doesn't know it, which is why I will say it every single time. And that mechanic is, hang on, let me run away first. That mechanic is, if you have Spear of the Magus on Fafnir and you're auto-attacking a tower, Spear of the Magus will lower that tower's protections. You know, by 50 max. Because your auto attacks are applying the ability damage. And Fafnir is the only one that can do that. And I will say that every single time. Because there's got to be at least one person that didn't know it. If you didn't know that, please comment. And tell me that you didn't know it. I'll show you when we're attacking the Phoenix. Because now we actually have our Spirit of Magus online. Alright, We can bait his escape pretty easily. We just need Gem Viso and to not waste our hammer as much. Oh no, this is bad. It's not that bad. That wasn't a stun bomb. Uh-oh. He wanted the Thorns to kill me. He wanted the thorns to kill me, but I didn't give him the chance. Yes. As usual, I have been underestimated. I gotta go ask him if he tried to let me kill him with the thorns. That was a pretty good Fafnir game, though. Yeah, but Specialist Blessing, like, you don't even get it for the Evolved Specialist Blessing. Although Fafnir can stack it super easily in his ultimate, that's not why you get it. You get it for the 10% cooldown reduction and 20 MP5. It helps so much early game, because if you don't go that, you're going to find that you're always backing as Fafnir because you keep running out of mana, or you're going to keep wasting your money on potions, you know? Specialist Blessing, unless you need the early clear super, super bad, then Mage's Blessing instead. But Bancroft's cooldown boots... Breastplate of Valor, this could be a Genji's if you're up against a Magical, or a Void Stone. Spear of the Magus, and then from there it's counter building. You get anti-heal if you need anti-heal, so I was getting anti-heal. You can get Gem of Iso if they're running away a lot. You can finish your cooldown if you're up against Magical and you don't have max cooldown. Let's say you went for a Nimeian instead because they're a super auto attack character and you're behind, then you can go for a Chronos Pendant also. That's also a good option. The only thing here is that my relics were countering Cupid. In general, Bracer is better against Fafnir. And maybe Blink. Sprint's pretty good, though, because upgraded Sprint gives you the hasten effect on Fafnir, which is pretty nice to chase people down in the dragon form. But that is all I have to say about that game. Hope you guys enjoyed it.